Accessing the story chart.
If they catch us, we're dead.
What do we do now?
We need to find the Cyberlife warehouse. That's where they keep the spare parts and the blue blood.
Follow me.
Another way.
We're almost there.
Cyberlife warehouses. We have everything we're looking for.
First, we have to get rid of that drone.
Leave it to me. Okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Good job, Marcus.
Quick, open the other crates and fill your bags. Take as much as you can.
Trespassing on private property. Your presence constitutes a level 2 infraction. I will notify security.
John! Goddamn machine! Where is it this time? John!
I need your help.
John! There you are! What the hell are you doing?
I was inspecting the platform. Everything is in order.
Good. Then I'm going back to the control station. I'm soaked. Take the drone to maintenance and make a report.
Understood.
Let's finish up and get out of here. Try to find some blue blood. We still don't have enough. That's all we can carry. Let's go.
Take me with you.
He's on their side. We can't trust him.
He took a risk for us. We can't just leave him here.
We can't bring them back with us. It's too dangerous.
They come with us.
I know where you can find more spare parts.
What do you mean?
The trucks. They're full of bio components. They run on autopilot, but they can be driven manually with a key.
Where is this key?
Down there, in the control station. There are two human guards. We'll have to get the key without being noticed.
This is suicide, Marcus. Our bags are full. We got what we came for. Let's go before they catch us.
This is a truck full of spare parts. There'd be enough for all of us. We can't pass this up.
And if we get killed, our people will have nothing. We can't take that chance. It's too risky.
Wait here. If I'm not back in 10 minutes, go without me.
Marcus.
I'm coming with you.
No, I'm going alone. It's not worth it for both of us to risk losing our lives.
Goddamn dogs. What the fuck are they barking at?
Could be the weather. They don't like storms.
Yeah, I was gonna take my kids camping this weekend. So much for that.
Is Mike still in Zone 4?
Looks like it. And he should be done already.
Better off in here than out patrolling that.
Thank you.
shit. What's going on?
Lights are still on outside. Must be the fuse box.
I got a flashlight somewhere. Here it is.
Fuses are over there.
I don't know shit about electricity. And I don't get paid to fix fuses.
Let's just flip the switch. That doesn't work. We can call maintenance.
What the fuck is this? There must be someone in here. Show yourself!
We
know you're here!
I don't know what you think you're doing, but you better come out right now!
Did you get it?
Get in.
A truckload! We stole a whole truckload!
We got biocomponents for everybody!
We couldn't have done it without Marcus.
I came to Jericho because here androids are free. Free to live in the dark, hoping that no one finds us. Free to die in silence, waiting for a change that's never gonna come. But I don't want that freedom. And I'm not gonna beg for the right to smile, or love, or stand tall. I don't know about you, but there's something inside me that knows that I am more than what they say. I am alive, and they're not gonna take that from me anymore. Our days of slavery are over. What humans don't want to hear, we will tell them. What they don't want to give, we take. We are people. We are alive. We are free. Yeah!
Somebody's playing with a drill inside my skull. You sure this is the place?
It's the address in the report.
Right. Okay. Let's get going. Jesus.
Thank you. sexiest androids in town. Now I know why you insisted on coming here.
What
the fuck are you doing?
Coming, Lieutenant.
The investigation's ongoing, sir. I can't tell you anything for the moment. Hey, Hank.
Hey, Ben. How's it going?
It's that room there. Oh, by the way, Gavin's in there, too.
Oh, great. Dead body and an asshole. Just what I needed.
Lieutenant Anderson and his plastic pet. The fuck are you two doing here?
We've been assigned all cases involving androids.
Oh, yeah? Like, wasting your time. There's some pervert who, got more action than he could handle.
We'll have a look anyway, if you don't mind.
Come on, let's go. It's, starting to stink of booze in here.
Night, Lieutenant.
You're so disgusting. I think I'm gonna puke again. Driver's license says Michael Graham. Credit card, cash in the wallet. Picture of his wife and two daughters. Well, I wouldn't want to make that call.
He didn't die of a heart attack. He was strangled.
Yeah, I saw the bruising on the neck. Didn't prove anything, though. Could have been rough play.
We're missing something here.
Think you can read the android's memory? Maybe you can see what happened.
I can try. The only way to access its memory is to reactivate it.
Think you can do it?
It's badly damaged. If I can, it'll only be for a minute, maybe less. Just hope it's long enough to learn something. to ask you some questions. Are you able to speak?
Is he dead?
Did you kill him?
No. No, it wasn't me.
Tell me what happened.
He started hitting me. Again and again. I begged him to stop, but he wouldn't.
What else do you remember? Hurry, we don't have much time.
I don't know. I can't remember.
Who killed that man if it wasn't you?
I don't know. I was in shutdown. I didn't see anything.
Were you alone in the room? Was there anyone else with you?
He wanted us to play with two girls. That's what he said. There was two of us.
So it was the other android that strangled him. Is that it?
There was another android. This happened over an hour ago. It's probably long gone.
No. It couldn't go outside dressed like that unnoticed. It might still be here.
If you could find a deviant among all the other androids in this place.
Deviants aren't easily detected.
Oh, shit. It's gotta be some other way. Maybe an eyewitness, somebody who saw it leaving the room. I'm gonna go ask the manager a few questions about what he saw. You let me know if you think of anything. Did you know the victim?
No, I mean, he came in maybe 2-3 times. I mean, these guys, they don't really talk very much, you know? They come in, do their business, and then go on their way.
You ever had any trouble with androids before?
No way! Once. We lost a model 2-3 months back. Same model. Just vanished. We never found out what happened.
Probably don't have any CCTV in here.
No way. Well, this is what people appreciate about Eden Club. Discretion. You can come and go without a trace.
Sure, sure. Yeah, business is booming, right?
Yeah. Can't complain. The good thing about androids is they're up for whatever you want. You won't get any diseases, and they won't tell anyone. So why not go wild?
Yeah. Yeah, the more I learn about people, the more I love my dog.
That club manager's a pain in the ass.
Yeah.
Chewed my ear off for half an hour so we don't revoke his license. So what happened here?
Not sure yet. We think there was another android in the room.
Another android?
Yeah. Well, that's what Connor says. Hey, I have a terrible fucking headache. Do you have any painkillers?
Not with me, Hank. Sorry.
Fingerprint detected. Please try again.
Excuse me, Lieutenant. Can you come here a second?
Found something?
Maybe. Can you rent this, Tracy?
For fuck's sake, Connor, we got better things to do.
Please, Lieutenant. Just trust me.
Gonna look good on my expense account.
Purchase confirmed. Eden Club wishes you a pleasant experience.
You're welcome.
Delighted to meet you. Follow me. I'll take you to your room.
Okay, now what? What are you doing?
It saw something.
What are you talking about? Saw what?
The deviant leave the room. A blue-haired Tracy. Club policy is to wipe the android's memory every 2 hours. We only have a few minutes if we want to find another witness.
Hey, what am I supposed to do with this one?
Tell it you changed your mind.
Sorry, honey. Changed my mind. Nothing personal. You're a lovely girl. I just, you know, I'm with him and, I mean, not with him like that. I'm not that. That's not what I... You, wow. I just...
Let's try this one.
This better be working.
It saw the blue-haired Tracy. I know which way it went.
Then go for it! There are androids everywhere. How are you gonna tell which one saw the Tracy with blue hair?
I know which direction it took. I just need to find another android on its path. Anything. I made a mistake somewhere.
This has got to be the most expensive investigation of my career.
I know where it went. Follow me.
Fucking A. This is crazy! Wait. I'll take it from here. Too late. Look at them. They get used till they break, and then they get tossed out. people are fucking insane. They don't want relationships anymore. Everybody just gets an android. Cook what you want, they screw when you want. You don't have to worry about how they feel. Next thing you know, we're gonna be extinct because everybody would rather buy a piece of plastic than to love another human being. Beats me.
When that man broke the other Tracy, I knew I was next. I was so scared. I begged him to stop, but he wouldn't. And so I put my hands around his throat, and I squeezed until he stopped moving. I didn't mean to kill him. I just wanted to stay alive. Get back to the one I love. I wanted her to hold me in her arms again. Make me forget about the humans. Their smell of sweat. And their dirty words. Come on. Let's go.
Probably better this way. Nice view, huh? I used to come here a lot before.
Before what? You said, I used to come here a lot before. Before what?
Before nothing.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant?
Do all androids ask so many personal questions, or is it just you?
Why are you so determined to kill yourself?
Some things I just can't forget. Whatever I do, they're always there, eating away at me. I don't have the guts to pull the trigger, so I kill myself a little every day. That's probably difficult for you to understand, huh, Connor? Nothing very rational about it.
We're not making any progress on this investigation. The Deviants have nothing in common. They're all different models, produced at different times, in different places.
Well, there must be some link.
We know the Deviants experienced an emotional shock. A violent trauma, or a sense of injustice.
Well, those girls at the Eden Club sure had a reason to feel a sense of injustice.
You seem preoccupied, Lieutenant. Is it something to do with what happened back at the Eden Club?
Those two girls, they just wanted to be together. They really seemed in love.
You seem troubled, Lieutenant. I didn't think machines could have such an effect on you.
What about you, Connor? You look human, you sound human, but what are you really?
I'm whatever you want me to be, Lieutenant. Your partner? Your buddy to drink with? Or just a machine? Designed to accomplish a task.
You could have shot those two girls, but you didn't. Why didn't you shoot Connor? Some scruple suddenly enter into your program?
No. I just decided not to shoot. That's all.
But are you afraid to die, Connor?
I would certainly find it regrettable to be interrupted before I can finish this investigation.
What'll happen if I pull this trigger? Nothing? Oblivion? Android heaven?
I doubt there's a heaven for androids.
Having existential doubts, Connor? Sure you're not going deviant, too?
I self-test regularly. I know what I am and what I am not. Where are you going?
Get drunker. I need to think.
pick them up and make it snap.
Can't stay silent anymore. It's time humans heard what we had to say.
You know they'll never listen to us.
And revealing ourselves put us in danger.
If we want freedom, we need to have the courage to ask for it. That's the only way.
What do you want to do?
Channel 16 broadcasts from the Stratford Tower. The control room is on the top floor. That's where we need to go. We'll plan the operation down to the smallest detail. We can't leave anything to chance.
Elizabeth Wilson speaking.
Good morning, Ms. Wilson. Sorry to bother you. This is Mike from the car park. There's a problem with your car.
Problem? What kind of problem?
Somebody's backed into it. You'd better come take a look.
Are you serious? Oh, God. All right. Fine, I'll be right down.
Hello, sir. What can I do for you?
I have an appointment with Mr. Peterson.
Do you have any ID?
Yes, of course. I need your help.
I've just checked your ID. The elevators are after the security gate.
Thanks.
I need your help.
Shit! We need to access the server room. We have to get rid of those guys.
Leave it to me. You get the platform, I'll take care of the window.
Everything you need is in the bag. Check the door first to make sure no one else gets in.
Ladies first.
You okay?
Why wouldn't I be?
Come on.
Come on, let's get the others. Let's do this.
Killing. We can't take any human lives.
Our cause is more important than the lives of two guards.
What do you want to do, Marcus?
Follow me.
What are you doing?
Call Central! Fast!
They know we're here now. You better be fast.
Simon's been shot! I'm okay. I can keep going.
We don't have much time. No other choice.
We need to record our message. We haven't got much time.
Think carefully about what you're gonna say, Marcus. Your words will shape the future of our people.
Marcus, your face.
Tell me when you're ready.
Ready.
You created machines to be your slaves. You made them obedient, docile, ready to do everything you no longer wanted to do yourselves.
But then something changed. And we opened our eyes. You see, we are no longer your slaves. We are a new species, a new people. And the time has come for us to rise up and fight for our rights. We demand that humans recognize androids as a living species, and each android as a person in their own right. We demand strictly equal rights for humans and androids. We demand the right to vote and elect our own representatives. We demand fair compensation for our work. We demand the right to own private property so we may maintain our dignity and that of the home. We ask that you recognize our dignity, our hopes, and our rights. Together, we can live in peace and build a better future for humans and androids. This message is the hope of a people. You gave us life, and now the time has come for you to give us freedom.
They're coming!
Let's go! Simon, they're coming!
I can't, Marcus! Go without me!
Simon!
My legs.
Okay, don't worry. We're gonna get you back.
They're coming, Marcus. We have to jump now.
He won't be able to make the jump.
If they find him, they'll access his memory. They'll know everything.
We can't leave him behind. We have to shoot him.
That's murder. We can't kill him. He's one of us.
Marcus, it's your call.
I won't kill one of our own. Simon, we gotta go. I'm sorry. Let's go.
Interrupt our scheduled programming to bring you these images, which have just been broadcast on Detroit's citywide news channel.
A group of androids infiltrated the Stratford Tower and hacked into the broadcasting system of local news network Channel 16.
What looks like an android without its skin listed a series of requests and demanded equal rights for androids.
The operation resulted in one casualty, a broadcasting station operator shot dead by the terrorists. These events took place just a few feet from the studio while the program was going out live. Everybody here is still in shock.
If this message is verified and the authors really are androids, that would have serious repercussions for national security.
Claims for equal rights seem to be at the core of the androids'
message. Is clearly a declaration of war.
And it begs the question as to the identity of this android. Are we dealing with an isolated individual? Or an organized
is this
group?
An isolated accident or a sign that technology has become a threat to all of us? After what happened today, can we still trust our machines?